Hello, my friends. Welcome once again to Faith Walk 101. We are so glad that you could join us. Well, I heard someone say that if you don't know your why, you will lose your way. You know, I find it amazing that today we celebrate so many man-made festivals, events, and special occasions. But if you were to go around and randomly survey people on the day that they're celebrating and ask them what that day meant, how this day got started, you might be surprised that many people don't know why they celebrate some of the things they celebrate. It is amazing. It kind of snowballs. We take on things, we celebrate things, and a lot of times we just don't know why we're doing it. That's not everybody, but you would be surprised. The number of people that celebrate holidays, they have no idea what it means or why they're doing it. So that statement, if you don't know your why, you lose your way. And I really believe that is so true. No, we will never understand everything, the reason why everything is. But I do believe that God has given us enough information to understand why we're here and His plan and purpose. And it's really unfortunate because I believe if you don't know why you're doing a lot of these things you're doing, you will lose your way. Christians and even the body of Christ itself. But what happens when those who are in Christ, those who are Christ followers, fail to teach a generation of God's people why God is what He does, why God's plan is in place, why God has a purpose? Eventually, over time, what happens is does this sense of why, our understanding of His plan and purpose, it gets replaced with this mass celebration where many Christians could not really tell you why they worship or even what they believe. Now, you might say, I don't believe that. That's hard to believe. You would be surprised. There are a number of Christians that go to church every Sunday, and they really cannot tell you why they believe what they believe. They really can't tell you why they do some of the things they do, why they worship, or even as simple as why they take the Lord's Supper. If you don't know your why, you will lose your way, and it is something that we have to continually teach. So what we've done, we have failed to understand why. It is so important to tell others the why. Where we do stuff. Because, you know, that's probably one of, used to be kids' favorite question, why? You know, they would just ask you why. And about so many different things, because they don't understand. And a lot of things that we ask our children to do, they may not understand why, but we should. Those who are given the instruction, the direction, should be able to understand why and be able to tell them someday when they're old enough to understand why these instructions have been given and why they're doing some of the things they're doing. If you don't know your why, you will lose your way. But if Christians don't know why, it is essential that you know why. It is just so important that we be able to understand why we do what we do and why we believe what we believe. You just cannot get by. You will lose your way if you don't understand why. Us understanding why is the foundation that we stand on. It's what keeps us from wavering in our faith. It keeps us from being tossed about to and fro because we understand what we believe, why we believe it, who Christ is, His plan and His purpose. And this is going to lead up to the lessons that we're going to be talking about in the future. So when you will become very complacent if you don't know why. So what we want to do many times is try to direct from the reason why by focusing on activities and celebrations. And so it's fun when we celebrate, we come together, we have a party, we fellowship, we eat, and those kinds of fun. I'm for that. I like it. But when the purpose, when the real meaning gets lost, of why we come together, when we lose our focus on this celebrating of being this happy day, this enjoyable day, we need to understand why. If we don't, then we lose our way. And I've been a part of so many celebrations where people get ugly, and they're not very nice, and they're not very friendly. And it makes you scratch your head. Okay, this is a celebration, and we understand why we come together, and that's where we should be joyful and enjoy the fellowship and lift one another up. But at the same time, we've become very ugly in our behavior. That's because we really don't understand why. If we don't understand why, we're going to lose our way. But still, if we don't know why, you should be happy, because we focus on the celebration. But the joy of our life is the joy of the Lord and the power of the Spirit that lives inside of us. And because of that, the hope that we have to be with Him and for Him returning. So there is no amount of celebration that can replace the not knowing why. But that's what we've done. We come together, we celebrate, and like I said, I've seen some celebrations where in the end they've turned out real ugly, where people are fighting, people get overexcited, full of things that they shouldn't be full of, and what started out as a fun celebration ends up as being an unhappy celebration. And for some people, it's even turned out to be a deadly one. We have to understand why. That's what keeps us on our foundation. We understand why. We know why. And we're going to talk about why we do what we do as Christians. Why so many people feel empty inside is because they really don't know why they're doing what they're doing. And so you can come to a celebration full of people, and everybody's laughing and seems like they're having fun, but there will be some people that are very empty inside, and maybe you have experienced that, just feel like something's missing, because we need to understand why we come together. We need to understand why we're celebrating, why we're worshiping. There is an ultimate goal, an ultimate plan according to God's purpose. This is not just a haphazard, have fun until you die life that we're living. God has a plan. He has a purpose. It is not ceasing. It's going forward, and He wants us to be a part of that. And so I've said all that to lead up to our next lesson, which is why Jesus is coming back. And you know, when Christians have decided that we're no longer going to advance the gospel, and some Christians, they might not say that openly, but everything about their behavior, their lifestyle, and what they're doing is sending this message: we're not going to advance the gospel. But what we're going to do is we're going to try to fix this world where people can live in peace without Jesus. And when I hear and see this example among Christians, what I say to myself is, they don't understand why, and they've lost their way. We cannot fix this world. And the main drive for us as believers is to advance the gospel. And if you think you can fix this world, it will not happen. I'll give you one example. You know that the amount of laws in this world, there are over 4 million laws that have been passed in this world, and the world still isn't any better. So we're going to keep passing laws. We're going to keep trying to fix this world. It's not going to happen. People need to know Jesus, and we don't want to get off track. So when we don't know God's why, then we have lost our way. Revelation chapter 21, John says, "Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth." My friends, make no mistake about it. There is going to be a new heaven and a new earth. I know even some Christians have lost their way on this sort of thinking that we're just going to have fun. We got our insurance ticket to heaven, and then we'll be gone. No, we're looking for King Jesus to come back to rule on this earth, where it will be a place where there will not be any more sin. It will be put down immediately. But we cannot do that because man does not have the capability to rule this world. He just does not. But Jesus does. And that's what we're looking for, a righteous king to rule this world. We're looking for his return. But as a Christian, are you looking for his return? I think a lot of Christians are not looking for the return of Jesus Christ. They've forgotten all about it because they've forgotten the why. This earth that man is trying to save without Jesus, it's not going to happen. These man-made laws and rules, they can't fix it because it's the heart of man. Man needs Jesus Christ. He needs Jesus Christ. And what we as believers need to do is advance the gospel. Tell people about the hope that we have inside of us, the reason why we do what we do, the reason why we believe what we believe. It will not change. God has a plan. He has a purpose. He's not altering it because you want to have a celebration and you don't even know what it's about. John says that he saw a new heaven and a new earth, and guess what? This earth is going to pass away. It's going to pass away, my friends. This is not a scare message. It's a reality that we as believers stand on. It's our hope that Christ will come and do away with all this evil and sin that's in the world, because we know that we cannot do it ourselves. Our role in this world is to advance the gospel. Please don't forget the reason why we're doing this. It has nothing to do with the man-made celebrations about having fun and forgetting about a lost world who really needs to know our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I hope this message has been encouraging to you, my friends. Continue to join us because we're going to talk about the reason why Jesus is coming back. There is a reason why. And I hope that we as Christians have not forgotten that reason.